And now we will see the results and consequences of choosing a specific company type when you create your QuickBooks file. Choosing a company type determines what owner's equity accounts will be put in the chart of accounts when QuickBooks automatically makes your chart of accounts for you when you create the file. It will determine what federal tax form your company will file or at least be matched to in the QuickBooks file. And you can change the company tax form in the My Company window anytime you need to. The equity accounts that QuickBooks put in the chart of accounts will not change, but you can edit those accounts very easily yourself, the way we learned in previous videos. When you first create your new company file in QuickBooks, you soon come to this window where it asks for your business name. And of course, when we choose industry, in the videos that I made, choose other none so that QuickBooks does not put a chart of accounts for you and you can put it yourself. However, when you choose a business type, there are some accounts that QuickBooks will put no matter what. That's because different types of companies file different tax forms. And here are the choices. So you can clearly see the reason why you choose a different company type is because QuickBooks needs to know what tax form your company will file. You can also choose it from the pull-down menu, and you see the company type and the tax form that gets filed with it are both here. Then you would just choose one, whichever one it is, click Create Company, and finish the setup steps. If you choose company type other none, these two are the equity accounts that QuickBooks will set up. And the one called retained earnings is the one that we were talking about in the previous video. This is the account that shows the accumulated net income for prior periods. Of course, the other equity account is opening balance equity, and I promise that every company type will have an opening balance equity account put in the chart of accounts no matter what. And I will clearly explain what that is in the video that follows this one. If you are choosing the sole proprietor of the company, then these are the equity accounts. You would still get opening balance equity. You would get owner's draw. And interestingly enough, the account that they put called owner's equity, that one actually is the retained earnings account. The one called owner's equity, if you choose type sole proprietor, that's the one that will accumulate the income and expense for prior years. You can rename it if you want, but the one that says owner's equity. So I don't know if they want you to combine the accumulated net income in the same account as the owner's investment. It might be a good idea to create a separate owner's investment account to separate it from what obviously is the retained earnings account. If you choose type partnership, you can see they give you a separate retained earnings account clearly labeled. Notice there's still an opening balance equity account here, and they also give you partner one draws and partner one equity and partner two draws and partner two equity. That's for the investment and the withdrawal of each individual partner. And of course, even though they give you an account clearly labeled retained earnings, and this account clearly is the account that I was talking about before that shows the difference between the income and expense, you would still have to do the procedures we learned about in the earlier videos to distribute the income. And you can rename these accounts or add accounts for additional partners. If you choose type corporation, QuickBooks will put these as the owner's equity accounts in your chart of accounts automatically. Now, to fully understand the equity accounts in a corporation, you might want to study some basic accounting and read the chapter of corporate accounting. Basically, dividends paid is similar to owner's withdrawals or owner's draws, the way it was mentioned in the partnership or the sole proprietorship, and capital stock is similar to the owner's investment account or the owner's capital. But again, there are extra details that you might want to study regarding the rules of accounting. The only one we're interested now in is the retained earnings account, because even a corporation has a retained earnings account that will hold the accumulated net income for prior periods. Even a tax-exempt organization that's not for profit has a retained earnings account. The earnings might not be distributed to the owners because there are no owners, but we still have an account in the chart of accounts in QuickBooks, even if the company is a not-for-profit organization. The other part of your file affected by the choice of which company type your company is the tax mapping on the form. This means you're telling QuickBooks the line on the company tax form that the accounts in the chart of accounts will be copied to. For example, your company's tax form is 1120. That means you told QuickBooks the type of company you have is a corporation. You can always check what type of company it is in the My Company window. For example, if you click Company, My Company, you can see this is Form 1120, Corporation. You chose corporation when you created this file. Now there's a line somewhere on the 1120 form for utilities expense. And we want to make the account in our chart of accounts called electric and gas expense map to that same line for utilities expense in the 1120 tax form. And if we change forms, the mapping will be lost. So how do we do this? Well, we go to List Chart of Accounts, and we find the account that we want to map to a specific line in the tax form for our company. We click Account Edit, and in the Edit Account window where it says Tax Line Mapping, we click here and we scroll down and look at every line on the 1120 form. Somewhere down here it is, Other Deductions Utilities. That means that the balance of this account is going to be transferred to that line on the 1120 form when our accountant imports the QuickBooks file into the tax software. And that's how you map it. Now remember, if you change forms, the mapping will be lost. So let's change the tax form to 1065 Partnership just to make the point. How do you change the company tax form? From the company main menu, choose My Company, then choose Pencil, then choose Report Information. So again, it's Company, My Company, click the pencil, and choose Report Information. Right now it's 1120. Now look what happens when we try to change it to 1065. We get this warning. Income tax settings now invalid and will be deleted in all accounts. Should we continue? Let's click yes just to see and click OK. Now when we go back to the chart of accounts and we edit the electric and gas expense, we say tax line mapping is now again unassigned.